As promised, it's time for part two of our video about Symbium, our favorite tool for SB9 and ADUs. We're going to run through an advanced way to use Symbium.com for those who are looking to acquire a site for an ADU or SB9. And as promised, we have an interview with Leila Banijamali, the CEO and co-creator of Symbium.com. Hey there. Christian Walsh, real estate agent with Wire Associates. This is the place where your real estate questions are answered and some answers are questioned. We're going to dive into more content on SB9. This is the number one channel to get that content. So if you're ready to learn how to use Symbium to find parcels for SB9 and ADUs, hit that like button and let's get started. And we're back. We promised to show some advanced features built into our favorite tool, Symbium. And we're here to show you what you're going to do is you're not going to enter an address. You're going to click advanced search and a whole new world will open up to you. And this is where the tool gets even cooler. You can use it backwards. What you can do if you're looking for a property where you can fit an accessory dwelling unit or take advantage of SB9 potentially, you can search the other way. If you want to buy that property, use it like this. So right now we're looking at the entire state of California. You can still enter an address and use the tool like it was used in the past video, but we are going to go ahead and take a look at the features and functionality built in. You can filter to find properties that are going to fit your needs. So here I am zooming in on Newport Beach. You could have used it up here. You could have typed in Orange County. You could have typed in the city. In fact, I'm going to do that. I'm going to type in Newport Beach, and that'll keep the filter in Newport Beach only. So now we're looking in the city limits. And here's where it gets cool. If you're going to build an ADU or you're going to take advantage of SB9, you may want to only focus on finding sites that are a certain size. So you, of course, could try to squeeze an ADU on a 6,000 square foot lot or do a lot split at 6,000 square feet. But let's go bigger. Let's try to find a lot that's at least 8,000 square feet. So we're going to use that minimum. That now becomes a filter. Now we're still too far out for that to actually show us. But as we zoom in, you're going to see that the areas that are at least 8,000 square feet are going to pop up. I know you're excited and you want to go ahead and take advantage of the tool right there. We've got the lot size. Let's get going. But don't forget, there's another important thing, and that is natural hazards. It will be difficult to have an ADU or have an SB9 lot split or duplex done in a high fire zone. So let's go ahead and take that out of the equation. We'll add in areas with no fire risk. And then one more, we'll do moderate because you can get away with moderate. And you can see that we lost some of our map. So if it's not purpley pink anymore, that means it's not going to apply. So we lost all these areas over here. Now let's zoom in. And now we have a better chance when we see a lot that's at least 8,000 square feet and is not in one of those fire zones. And we can see we lost some over here that we had. But these areas, these are the ones that now qualify that aren't fire hazard zones or moderate fire hazard zones, and they're at least 8,000 square feet. So why is this tool so helpful? This is helpful for you to go ahead and find potential parcels. So if you're out there looking to acquire a parcel, this is what you can do is you can run it through this filter to see if you can find in a neighborhood parcels that'll work for you. So here, this happens to be Irvine Terrace in Corona Del Mar. And we see that these lots are at least 8,000 square feet and they're not in the high fire zone risk area. Now, the other thing we'd have to do is check zoning. I happen to know this is the proper zoning for SB9 because it's R1. For ADUs, it can be a single family residential zone or it can be multifamily zone. So this is an advanced way to use the Symbium tool. Use it backwards. So you're not just looking at a parcel that you already own, but this would be a way to use it for parcels that you could potentially acquire. I'm very excited to be introducing Leila Banijamali, and she is amongst many other things, including an attorney, a real estate agent, Stanford grad, is also CEO and co-creator of one of my favorite tools, Symbium, that I recently featured on my channel. and will continue to use. So Leila, thanks for coming. I'm excited to do this interview. I promised my viewers I'd be interviewing you, and I know some of them maybe didn't believe me, but I got you, see?
Here we are. Yeah, anytime, Christian. I'm happy to come back for a sequel as well. But, you know, we actually at Symbium, we are fans of your videos. I was just telling Christian that offline that, you know, some of us watching, he's got such a great, you know, persona about him. It's really an honor for me to be here and happy to help you out.
That's very nice. Flattery will get you everywhere, Leila. Thank you. Secretly, I've been using your tool for a while, particularly with SB9. Now, it's set up for accessory dwelling units. But secretly, I've been using it with SB9 because it is so easy to use. Literally, you type in symbium.com and you type in the address. That's all you need. And it pulls up all these functions and features and translates code. How do you do that? Because all throughout just like Orange County, where I'm based, code can be very different from area to area. And then just go ahead and layer on what do we have, 57, 58 counties in California. And things are very different.
I mean, it's an exciting problem. You know, like I think in order to understand sort of what, you know, what our story is and what is the story behind our vision, we have to understand why is this a problem worth solving? So I think I'd like to start by talking a little bit about that. How did Symbium get to become this property information portal that so many real estate agents and homeowners rely on? You know, it's a free portal. Anyone can access it, symbium.com. And the idea is to give people turn-by-turn directions as to what's possible on their particular property. We've covered all of California properties, and we'll expand out from there. But today, we're focused on California. So, you know, we came into this out of Stanford realizing right at the outset, well, you know, what vertical do we want to be in? Well, the largest vertical in the planet is government. And within government, planning, because planning is the core of every city's activities. You know, how many times as a real estate agent have you heard from your clients something like, is it possible for me to build this? Or can I open a coffee shop in that location? Or is this thing in the backyard even permitted? And of course, the problem with something not being permitted is it may not get financing, right? So what we know is the government ecosystem today is badly broken. The data is fragmented, the data about my property and any property that I want to look at. It's largely inaccessible and it's hard to understand. We don't know also what are we allowed to do or what are we required to do. For that, you know, there's so many different ways of finding out, but none of them are really effective. In other words, this lack of transparency around where do you go, who do you seek help from, what are the next steps, and how does the law apply to my particular situation, particularly with regards to properties, is the problem that Symbium is facing. So as a homeowner, if I want to build a deck, or if I want to advise, if I was a working real estate agent, if I wanted to advise my client, you know, whether or not they can add 1,000 square feet, or if my client wanted to go find out for themselves how to do that, how do you do that? Well, three options. You can look it up yourself. You know, it requires knowledge of where to look. You got to look at the planning codes and, you know, read through regulations and associated amendments and cross-references. This is a prohibitive task, even for professionals. So second option is you call the local government office. I will likely receive, if I do that, a different response if I talk to planner A versus planner B. Third option, yes. Hire an expensive planning consultant to do that work for me, which entails many of the same problems that I already mentioned with the added inconvenience of time and money lost. So in each of these instances, I feel like I have no control. I'm still in the dark, and it's an iterative process that has to happen over and over again. But this lack of knowing is the worst part of it. That's the problem.
No, you are so spot on, Leila. And I can tell that with your amazing background you have in real estate and law, not to mention technology, you get it. And that's the thing when I'm advising clients about what they can do to their property, I will tell them the very things you've just said. The fact that you can go into the planning commission, you can pick up the phone and call a few different ones. You go to the planning counter, you ask a few questions, you try to understand what you can do, and you're right, you'll get different answers. And a lot of times the answer will be no. And there won't be any sort of workaround. They won't try to work with you to figure out, well, maybe if you just move this wall a foot, suddenly it's a yes. And that's what I love about the tool you guys have created, is it's almost like a coloring book and helping you figure out coloring in the lines, like what you can do on any piece of land in California. And then from there, print out the ADU report, for example, that you guys have. And you can bring that to the planning desk and you can talk through it. And you feel like you understand a little bit more. You don't have to know the exact code, but you certainly can make progress in going in when you've got that out in front of you, instead of just walking in and say, hey, what can I do with this? What can I do with my backyard?
So if we're trying to talk about the ideal experience from our perspective, it's to put that feasibility and that control of what can I do on this property? What am I allowed to do? What am I required to do? Put that control right into the hands of the public. You know, this ideal experience should completely transform your expectations of how you interact with your property's data, right? It's not good enough to just go to Zillow and Redfin and Trulia and all those other sites and see like, okay, they kind of have all the same data, right? What if you had the instant ability to see the totality of that data, and that basically you had the opportunity to perform hypotheticals or what if scenarios, right? What if I wanted to put this ADU in my backyard? What would that look like? How much does it cost? Where exactly can it be located? That's the beauty of computational law, or comp law, there goes my dog. You know, as we do it, we've basically taken this concept of comp law and incorporated the regulations, the planning regulations, right into Symbium.com, so you can visualize what's possible on your property.
I use Symbium for SB9 in addition to accessory dwelling units. And I'll have a link to the video so you can see that if you haven't. SB9 is another exciting opportunity for homeowners. And again, whether it's land that you own already. I've talked to plenty of folks from all over California. They've got an extra parcel or an extra land that they potentially could subdivide. They want to know more. I've hacked it for SB9. Are you open to maybe adding in a few SB9 tools?
Absolutely. Okay, yeah, good. Absolutely. I think, you know, what's important from our product perspective is that constant iteration and that feedback loop from the public. We actually have a very easy email to remember, hello@symbium.com. If you have feedback that you want to share about a feature that you want to see, all you need to do is send it to that email, and it will go on our list of things to put in our roadmap.
And at the end of the day, and I don't talk about this enough on my channel, but I'm excited about creating housing. California needs more housing. We have a severe housing affordability crisis, housing crunch. We don't have enough of it. So I want to compliment you guys on creating a tool like Symbium to help the public, to help be part of the solution. We don't have to wait for anybody else to come to us and say, hey, you could do this on your land. Like, we can do it ourselves. We can figure it out. Now, it's not easy. This is just the first step. And your tool shows us what's possible, gives us an idea of what it'll cost for the accessory dwelling. I love the fact that there's even potential plans that you can put in your backyard. You could even see a potential ADU back there. So I just want to compliment you on that. And it's something I take very seriously, increasing the amount of housing we have in California. So thank you guys for creating something like this to help with that. What do you see for the future of Symbium? Where do you see you guys heading next with the tool?
Yeah, it's great. So first of all, thank you so much, Christian. You know, this means a lot to know that there's professionals out there that have specific use cases using the tool in their own businesses, and it's useful to their customers and clients. So, you know, what I can say, there's a lot of sort of secrets that we have about new products that we're going to roll out, which is super exciting. You guys are going to love it. One thing that is sort of a value that's very, very important to me and ideal that we maintain is all of this experience around search and analysis and what's possible. We always want to maintain that as a free service to the public. I want to make sure that that is 100% clear. So we always get that question. I was like, well, you know, what does it cost? Like, we're paying for services that don't even, or tools that don't even provide half the functionality of this. You guys must be charging something. The answer is no. So, you know, I think the future for us is going to be allowing people not just to understand what's possible on their properties, but actually performing transactions. So actually getting stuff built, you know, connecting with the marketplace of vendors and, you know, submitting their permit applications right through Symbium. So I think those are going to be really, really exciting new features for us. And I think they're, hopefully we can charge a small service fee for helping people submit their applications, which I think people will gladly do. And there we can provide a lot of real value. But, you know, these services that are charging people subscriptions and, you know, freemium models to have access to a little bit more data on their search platforms, I think is rubbish. This is all public data. It should be available for free, and everyone should have a much nicer way of navigating it all. And that's why we're here.
I appreciate that about keeping it free, because when I first found your tool, and I even joked about it in the video, I'm like, all right, when are they going to ask me for my credit card? I know it's going to be here. And then I click, no, didn't ask me for a credit card. And that happened like 3 or 4 times. And I'm like, this thing's totally free. And for a minute I thought, I wonder if they know that it's all free.
It's broken.
Literally. Yeah. Right. I thought I maybe found a back door in, but no, literally it's free. So no, I think that's spectacular. If you could make it easier for people to start the permitting process on an ADU, or maybe add in something with SB9. We'll work on that together.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, that's worth its weight in gold. Well, I want to thank you very much for being on here. This is the first of many interviews.
Wait,
to
what?
Come.
We're not talking for a few more hours?
Well, I could, but I know what'll happen is that you'll fall asleep if I keep talking. So some of those secret things that you hinted at, we better be able to get a scoop on at least one or two of those here on this channel.
Absolutely. We'll be happy to launch it here. You got it, Christian.
Let us know in the comments below what your SB9 questions are. Make sure you subscribe to our free weekly email newsletter where we cover SB9 plus market updates, landlord-tenant law, and a whole lot more. And make sure you check out the rest of the videos in the SB9 playlist right here. Thanks for tuning in. This has been Christian Walsh, real estate agent with Wire Associates, and we want to hear from you.